In my last video, I tried to convince you that it would be interesting to know your GFR because I like to keep an eye on my organs, but us commoners don't have access to GFR testing. So I make do with my eGFR, which is what's on your regular old blood tests. And if you don't see it on yours, I'll show you how to calculate it later on. So eGFR is meant to be an accessible measure of your kidney function, but I do have to warn you, it's a pretty boring number. Even actual doctors seem like they want to fall asleep when they're describing it. Plus, it's not even a real measurement. It's just a formula that's taking credit for another measurement's hard work. But that lets it be smarter than the measurement it's based on. So what's the number actually telling us? The only metaphor I could come up with is based off this $150 rain gauge product. I guess there's some kind of market of farmers who are rich and love steampunk. The meter works by having the cylinder fill up with rain, which moves the arm to point to the number of inches of rain that you got. And I think of eGFR as the same type of meter, except you don't have to sell a kidney to afford it. So with eGFR, the rain is your creatinine level, and that measurement is used to point to an estimate of your remaining kidney function. And that makes sense, because generally, the more poorly your kidneys are working, the higher your creatinine is going to be, because that
glomerular filtration rate
of your kidneys has gone down. You can see that inverse relationship on my blood test here. When my creatinine goes up, my eGFR goes down. But that's more useful to have than it might seem if you saw my criticisms about reading too much into your creatinine levels, because eGFR has adjustments for some of those creatinine confusers. So let's refine the rain gauge metaphor. Let's say you bought the gauge, but you're not this ridiculous caricature I made up. You're a totally different person. You're a rich steampunk farmer, but you like the metric system. All you'd have to do to have the meter report rain in centimeters is to bend this arm so that it points to a larger number for a given amount of rain in the cylinder. Then you avoid those disturbing American inches. And that same arm bending technique happens when eGFR is calculated. There's these different formulas that take into account things like your age, your sex, and your race to bend the arm so that a doctor can interpret the same creatinine number differently for different types of people. So for example, every year you get older, the arm is going to be bent a little further down because it's increasingly more likely that you having a high creatinine level is due to your kidneys declining, not that your muscle mass has grown with age. So those formulas are a clever way to get more out of what was just a simple measurement, but it can unnecessarily scare people because it's presented in those terms that imply you've been tested for kidney damage when that's not quite true. Not to rehash my creatinine video, but this number has those same weaknesses where it's like trying to figure out whether your pool is draining when your drunk dog is at the other end refilling it. And fitness type people who are more likely to pay attention to their numbers anyway might be more prone to seeing scary results because they might have a lot of muscle or be dehydrated or take creatine. When there's nothing actually wrong with their kidneys, eGFR is just too dumb to understand that their blood is unique. And I think the terminology even trips up real medical professionals. I notice a lot of doctors being scared that people's creatine supplementation is hurting their kidneys, probably just based on how creatine changes this number. If you ever want to look at your eGFR over time like I do, just know that the specific formula that was used for the arm bending might be different depending on when it was done and what lab was used. Or it might even intentionally not be reported to you as anything other than greater than 60, which does have some logic to it, even though it's annoying. But for any of those cases, you can just standardize the values yourself from your creatinine number, which you will have, by punching it into online calculator tools. Now, I personally don't even need these calculators. I can just do the formulas in my head. Like, I can immediately tell you that a creatinine of 0.8 is JavaScript error. Finally, if you're the type that likes memory devices, the phrase egg farts won't help. Next video will be about your buns and why they get bigger. And please subscribe if you haven't, because I am only 17 of you beautiful people away from being able to unlock a URL that isn't for robots.